Yeah, one of the reasons we started this project is that reaction engineering, the course which we're using it in, is really difficult to build a laboratory around, because this involves, like, you know, gigantic reactor vessels and, you know, arranging configurations of reactors on an industrial scale, and, like, piping and heating and cooling. And so by putting it in this context of, you know, small 3D printed chemical reactors, the students can do something that's really complex and expensive that normally wouldn't be possible.
I'm going to try something crazy. Let's see if this works.
This is our augmented reality table, and it uses computer vision to recognize objects. So we have two types of object that represent two different chemical reactors. This is a CSTR, this is a PFR, and on the bottom they have two different symbols. All of the ones of the same type have the same symbol so that the computer can recognize them. And underneath this glass here, there's just a camera pointed at the back of the screen that recognizes the images projected. The projector underneath projects the visuals that let the users know what's going on.
So this is the control panel for the software that we have. This is what the camera sees when you place objects. So this part shows how the background subtraction is. So when you remove the background, the camera only sees the objects that you place. And based on the feed that the command center gets, the simulation happens and it's projected via the projector.
When I came to my students with the idea about doing something in augmented reality, we iterated a lot about what would be the best way to accomplish this so that students could collaborate and have it be tactile and be interactive. So we came up with this idea of this table here with the glass surface with the projector underneath and a webcam underneath. And my student, Rainier, had a background in carpentry, luckily, and so he was able to construct this in just a couple weeks. And Heta, the other student who works with me, she helped a lot too and learned a lot about woodworking. And as a group, we painted it together, and we like worked on the weekend on getting this whiteboard paint to work. And so it actually is a functioning whiteboard, which is really exciting.
Because it's an open inquiry, it invites many diverse inputs or on-ramps for learners. So they can bring many different ways that they understand chemical reaction engineering to the literal table and reason with those understandings. They get to use their own language, and all of that is really important for nurturing diverse participation in STEM, which is a goal of all of ours.
Before this sort of tool, you would have to either do it pen and paper style, where you basically solve a system of equations and calculate essentially these numbers, the final yield of the entire system. So we're doing everything except the last step for the students by simulating this display and letting them sort of play around with it by hand instead.
Far as a big advantage I see is you can like try different things and just see what happens without having to go make an Excel spreadsheet and like type out all the calculations, and then it gives us kind of something really visual, which is good. So rather than looking at like little words on our cells in Excel that say like PFR and it looks at like 30 different temperatures, you can literally sit here, spin the dial, change the temperature, put a new reactor on and see what it does.
Oh. There it is.
When we did our first trial, we compared augmented reality to a control group in the other room. The experimental group that got to use augmented reality did at least 3 or 4 times as many trials as the group in the control. We also found that the AR table learners scored higher on their conceptual assessments, but I think what matters most is that they had an opportunity to really use their understandings in a meaningful context.
And that's sort of the philosophy of this approach, is that augmented reality allows us to go after concepts that are normally inaccessible to laboratories. So something like quantum mechanics, something like wave mechanics at like a planetary scale, or chemical reaction networks. We can approach these in a way that students can still get that hands-on learning they would get in a normal undergraduate laboratory, but in classes where this is impossible.
Yeah, there it is.
There we go.
So let's do this first.
There it is.